Smart Wargames hier. Let's do a Windows 10 guide for using the Viking Steel in the North Atlantic Strategic Campaign mod. I talked about it in the last video, however, there was something with the sound messed up because of DOSBox or whatever. So let's do another one, a quick one. Hit this page here, you will find a campaign expansion for Viking Steel similar to a older game called Great Naval Battles. Viking Steel, great naval game, but the campaign was somewhat limited to this resolving around managing ships in some random in a series of random battles, so not really the operational experience some might look for. But it is possible to, some modders got this working and it seems fine. I will explain how you can make it run in Windows 10 and how to use it. Sound check.
How you can make it run in Windows 10 and how to use it.
Okay, no interferences. So take a look at this, that's how it looks, and download it here, beta 0.4, and go into your game install. How to set up Viking Steel for Windows 10, check out my recent video. I have made one with commentary. It is not yet uploaded. I need to piece it together and will upload it, where you get all information how to make it beauty and play it in full HD resolution and Windows 10. You will receive some files and which you are asked to throw into the main folder, which comes also with a README. Check it out. There's a lot of instructions how to play it. I will give you a short overview how it works out. One thing, it requires some tinkering around before it works in Windows 10. There is a file coming which you start the campaign with, FSNR, but you need to modify it. And yes, it is somewhat older project. It was made for Java 1.1. Java is, I don't know, now 8.0, whatever. It won't work out of the box even if you have the recent Java installed. Perhaps some people with Java experience know how to set up those lines that it will work with the newest Java. If you know, let me write please a comment, because then we can skip this. However, there is a possibility to use this vintage Java. I found it on the internet, Google it. I don't want to recommend sources. You can also find them on Oracle themselves or whatever, whoever is responsible. However, the problem is it doesn't run in modern systems because it won't run. It's because it's a 16-bit application and Windows 10 dropped the support for it. I've put it into a virtual machine of Windows XP, quickly installed it and extracted the files. Extracted the 1.1 file, just a folder, installed in programs, and simply put it into my Java folder. And then I used the path here, those two paths that are required here, and updated the file in this bat modify. Yeah, one is pointing towards this bin folder, the other one is pointing towards this lib folder. And let's test it out. It is running. So you will get upbooted with a campaign screen, German Navy, Royal Navy, three campaigns available. However, the README states only German. I mean, they said if you press Royal Navy, it will terminate. Nothing happens. Better restart it. So currently, I guess it's not further developed, but German is working. Started. You are presented with a tactical screen, which I can't resize. The screen comes in a size of 800 by 600. If you want to use it full screen, I can't do it on stream because it will mess up the stream. Put your screen resolution of your desktop on 800-600 just for the game. You will get quite a full screen experience. Now you say, okay, but I want to play Viking Steel because you will play the battles in the real game in full HD. Doesn't matter if you put your Viking Steel with Voodoo into, for example, I played in full HD 1920. The game will simply switch to this resolution, and if you end it, the desktop will switch back to this lower resolution in order to give a bigger campaign map. How to do everything of this? check out the setup video for Viking Steel itself. So we have a campaign screen here, and yeah, let's set it to, in order to initialize it, some time, and let's zoom into the main AO. And yeah, it is simple, it is nothing over complicated, but still offering more immersion and more operational experience than the main game. And yeah, it is similar to this Naval Battles game, which is this the title that some consider as before a previous title of this series. And yeah, definitely a good option. There's a second campaign mod you can buy from NWS. When I'm set up, I will make a video about it. So, and then you can set up patrols or whatever. For example, we have one base here, available ships, arrivals. You can check out what ships arrive when. Even this mod comes with ship buckets, everything really interesting. And what ships are unavailable because of damage or whatever. Let's design a quick new task force. We call the task force raiding force. And what was it? Three or four divisions you can put in Viking Steel. I think three divisions. Yeah, you first start with divisions. I will now select the Gneisenau and the Scharnhorst for raiding. And let's get some cruiser scouting force with them. Another division of like cruisers, the Karlsruhe and the Königsberg for scouting. Two divisions is fine, create the task force, and they will be created and appear on the map. Let's run it a bit on, so we can select it. They receive some automatic orders, which I don't want. I want to set the path myself. We will raid somewhere here in the north. Okay, stuff is happening in this campaign. There are buttons, all buttons are explained in this README file. And yeah, in order to get out of this waypoint mode, click on land. Okay, now let's speed up because I want to make it short, the video. Ah, we really didn't encounter anybody. Okay, let's pause again. I need to set up more waypoints. I was expecting to encounter somebody. Let's go a bit more cocky and hit those British, because I'm pretty sure they will come out at one point. There's a patrol in Denmark. I guess it's not our patrol. I don't know what OB stands for. Of course, you could operate multiple forces. Okay, we got spotted. You could now get us some, I don't know, raiding ships out or battleships. Okay, there are not that many in World War II, but there's a force incoming. I guess there's some. Looks like really nothing that much happening. What the heck happened now? Wait. Okay, perhaps we can intercept this patrol here. You can also get ships out of the task forces if you want to split them. Okay, now something happening. We intercepted something. We don't know exactly what. Now you presented this. Normally the README suggests that the game will automatically start. It doesn't. Not sure what the reason is. However, the campaign generated a scenario. And we will now start Viking Steel. Go to scenario, editor scenarios, and you will find this FSNR scenario, which was automatically generated from this campaign module. Go in, play the Germans in what mode, I guess standard mode. Set your preferences, continue. Yeah, you see that's the ships we assigned on the campaign map, two light cruisers, two battle cruisers. And go. Yeah, this wobbling is coming from. Okay. I won't play this battle now in a serious fashion. I will speed up, and in order to get contact, make some pew pew, and perhaps even die. I don't care. I just want to show you how. Okay, we made some contact. Yeah, let's deactivate the auto camera. It is night, so I guess the engagement distance is quite short. Yeah, we are engaging. Ooh, armored cruisers right beside. Yeah, it's just. They basically encountered each other at, yeah, they're firing star shells. Wait, the time is just super fast. And now everything is lighting up. Let's quickly go to the map to set some waypoints here. I simply want to, you need to hit this button here. Division orders. Yeah, let's go full intercept. Full speed. Division 2. You as well. Intercept. Full speed. Okay. Yeah, and we need to set targets for both divisions. So we have some nice firing here. It's the primary battery, secondary battery, threat targeting. Let's do illumination because it looks really great. Threat illumination. Yeah, they're tuning their searchlights and really like the features of the night combat here. Same for the light cruisers. Main batteries, threat targeting, secondary batteries not available. Illumination not available, at least not proper one. And that's it. Let's watch the battle. I will now accelerate it in order to get quickly through it. Yeah, let's keep the camera controls. And yeah, we will commence this battle, but you could also do, for example, you could get, it really looks great in this game, night combat. Yeah, let's accelerate. Castle was sinking. Let's broadside them. But this is not a tutorial how to make naval warfare. I'm even suiciding here because I just want to get quickly out of this. That somebody comes with some Inspector Columbo comment. You should have done this or that. That's absolutely inappropriate and not needed. Thanks. Yeah, select Division 1. Yeah, they running. Okay, yeah, sure. Whatever. It's fine. We don't need orders. Simply get over it. And you could also run away. Yeah, if it was, let's say we would encounter a stronger force, and you battle cruisers are really fast. You of course want to run away. You can do it, and then use this, also this acceleration feature here, the super acceleration feature. This here, this. Accelerate to end if you're disengaging and out of contact in order to get quickly back to the campaign screen. But we will simply play out this battle, perhaps eat some torpedoes. Both light cruisers are sunk, collision or whatever is going on there. One light cruiser sunk. Newcastle burning, star shells are fired. Smoke screens deployed. We lost one of the battle cruisers, which would be quite a loss. Really? Yeah, one of the battle group. No, it's here. It looks like they're disengaged for some. Ah, some new division appeared. Yeah, because they are too slow or whatever, disengaging. Yeah. The Gneisen now is running away. Or the Scharnhorst perhaps received too much damage. I don't know. They simply want to get rid of it. I like the ballistics in this game. Newcastle is going down. Okay, let's put out the elimination. Enough for a raiding. And let's disengage. I mean, some ships were sunk. For example, some light cruisers.
Sir, an enemy ship has sunk.
Newcastle sunk. And if you would have done this battle correctly, you could have raided all those British away. Because, so, disengaging here, let's accelerate the game. Good. Yes, before you do anything, you need to do something manually because, yeah, you need to hit, I guess, the all ship screen. Exactly sure. Wait, is this the damage points? I guess so. But 11? That's quite low. Show victory points, show. Mission points, damage points, yeah, but damage points seem to be, yeah, damage points are same as victory points. Okay, so you will go in the screen, make a screenshot, or you can also tap out, which is, but if you have a smartphone, make a screenshot of this, because now you need to get here, the battle is over, and there is no, it seems this is not possible for the game to tell the campaign what happened. You need to input it manually. You press continue and you present it with all ships that participated. Really like those ship buckets. For example, the Newcastle definitely got sunk and you press sunk. It is marked sunk. Let's say the Frobisher got away but was damaged with. Why is it four numbers? Because the number looks quite high. So sunk ships only have 118. Yeah, whatever, let's test it out. Is it, let's say some of those ships, Frobisher 14. Because I'm myself not exactly sure if this 14. If I press continue. Sure if I'm doing correctly. Do I need to press continue? If I what did the Germans suffer? Karlsruhe sunk, Königsberg 11. Karlsruhe sunk, Königsberg 11. Why is this number so big? Do I need to put it on 1100 damage points? Wait, is there some other stats? Damage points. The number seems so big. Damage points. The number here is so small. And the other thing, it's so big. Yeah, consult a readme, but I'm not exactly sure myself. This is of course important information, but let's say, because here it's 8,000. I guess this is the amount that is available. So this is not saving. One, zero, Gneisenau, one damage point, three. Another value is three, super small. Gneisenau, one. Okay, and that's it. Sunk ships will now be removed. Yeah, but you get the idea. I'm not exactly sure. I mean, something happened at 100, perhaps one point is the system is handling it different, the campaign system than the in-game system, but as you see, there is a difference. It's rather looking small, but perhaps they didn't receive as much damage. I can't tell. We didn't have, unfortunately, a really heavy damaged ship. Should have tried out what. And but that's how it works, and then you can continue your campaign. And yeah, save. You can save here. Test save. And play it in a fashion. Test it out. I didn't play it too much. Can't tell about how good the experience is. It's an idea. It is still better. Or will also stay better. I mean, I don't think it is still developed. And yeah. Okay, that's it.